In this video series, we're going to capture how you can design a wire harness using SolidWorks Electrical. And in this first video, we're going to highlight some general purpose 2D drawing tools, creating a single line diagram, and capturing manufacturing information about the components in our design. Now, in the upper left-hand corner, we're looking at a basic illustration of our system with a printed circuit board, enclosure, and a display and the connectors that are associated with them. Now what we want to do is use some general purpose 2D drawing tools to continue the illustration of showing the harness portion of our design. So I'm simply going to sketch this out using the line tool here to get this in place. And this information doesn't have any intelligence to it at this point. All we're looking at is, again, 2D tools to capture an illustration. And this is pretty much the extent of functionality you would get from a traditional 2D CAD package. Lines, blocks, fillets. Now what we want to do is highlight the intelligence you can build into your electrical design using the ECAD tools from SolidWorks Electrical. So we'll start by working on our single line diagram information. And I'm going to go to my symbol palette and search on the components that I require. It is a very comprehensive library of symbols that's available, and we're looking at single line diagram symbols right now. So here I'm going to say let's look for our connector. You can see we have our list of connectors here, and I'm going to place one in the middle that's going to represent my PCB connector. And we'll also place connectors in here for the other component connections. Now for my other symbol, I'm just going to hold down my control key and just slide it across and get that in place. So it's a quick way to get additional copies onto my single line diagram. Now, as we're doing this, SolidWorks Electrical is automatically filling out the information in the database. You'll notice next sequential numbers are created for the marks. I have X1, X2, and X3. That's also filled out on my component palette, where I can see here I have X1, X2, and X3 all within the enclosure. Now, these are the locations for my design, and I only have an enclosure in there. What I want to do is I want to define that detail graphically on my schematic so it's very clear to the person reading the drawing. So I'll go to my line diagram tools here and have a location outline where I can place in there that this is going within my enclosure. So it makes it very clear that's where X2 is connected. And I'll also add locations for my PCB. Create a new location for that very quickly and easily. Again, graphically shown on the screen. And we'll place that in here as well. We'll place the location outline for our display. Now again, as we're doing this, SolidWorks Electrical is automatically updating the database, helping us organize our design. Now from here, what we want to do is add some cable, and I can use my single line diagram cable tool to quickly get that in place. And the documentation we've created at this point for our single line diagram makes it very easy to communicate how this may go together in the early stages of a project. I have a very simple illustration created with my general purpose 2D tools, as well as I'm using single line diagram information about the components, such as my connectors, their locations, and cables to show how they're connected. And while I'm doing this, the information is filled out in the database so it's able to be used downstream in my detailed schematic. Now from here, let's capture manufacturing part information about the components. And we'll take a look at our display component first. Go ahead and just say, let's assign parts to this. Maybe I've determined from my display requirements that I'm going to need 5 circuits for that. And it quickly narrows down my list. I've also narrowed down my list based on manufacturer. There's other filter criteria that we can include on this, and once we have our list down to a size that we want to work with, we can start looking at the details of the connections of that component. And from here, we'll select that component, and you can see that no longer are we just looking at the location and the component mark to this, but we see the manufacturing information on the component symbol. We'll do the same thing for the other side. Assigning part information to this very quick and easy. We have a very comprehensive library of information to work from. So in this case here, we're going to add the female pin version of this connector. So we can't accidentally mix up the connections when we're putting this together on the physical assembly. Last component here. Again, we'll assign parts to this. We're going to need more connections for this example to support both of the other connectors in the harness. Again, we can preview the information associated with just by simply selecting the components on the list. Now, as this information is filled out, the manufacturing part info, the location, all those details are able to be reused downstream in our reports, the bills of materials, and in the detailed electrical schematics. So in this video, we highlighted how you can use general purpose 2D drawing tools to create a simple illustration of your physical design. We captured a single line diagram that has intelligent data behind it about your electrical design. It shows the manufacturing info, cable connections, and the locations of those components. So I hope you found this information helpful. And if you have any follow-up questions, you can contact us at prismeng.com. And be sure to tune in for some more great tips and tricks.